How are you spending your Friday nights? Toasting your own marshmallows? Fire pit need rekindling? Come on, join us every Friday night at the fire pit, where our conversation really heats up!
Cynthia, and I hope she's on.
Hey.
Hey, girl, how are you?
I'm all right. I'm iChatting, you know, I'm not crazy about the iChat.
I know, but how else can we communicate like that?
That's true. I like your hat.
Oh, hey, thanks.
So you can wear hats. I can't do the hat thing.
Oh, you can borrow my hat anytime, girlfriend.
Thank you, sister.
Hey, listen, I wanted to ask you a question.
Okay, go ahead, shoot.
If you have time available today, would you like to go downtown in Nashville and kind of walk around and reminisce about the year 2008 with Fire Pit Friday?
Yeah, sure. Is lunch involved? You know I'm all about the lunch.
Yeah, actually, we can go to Pita Pit.
All right, good. Let's go. When do you want to go?
Well, we should go now.
I can get off the computer.
Yay!
All right, let's go.
All right, let's go.
Let's go.
Here we are on Printer's Alley, mm-hmm. Right?
Printer's Alley. I mean, we live in Nashville, although we're not from Nashville.
No, we're New Yorkers.
We're New Yorkers, but living here in Nashville, it's been great. And having Fire Pit Friday and meeting you for the first time.
I know. Can you believe it's almost a year?
Mm-mm.
So much has happened in that year.
So much has happened. Your interview, the very first time I met you, your interview was fabulous.
Uh-oh.
Well, we're
fabulous.
That's what I love about you. Yeah, and then we just kind of, ideas started just...
Yeah, we clicked.
Yeah.
No, you know what it is? Both you and I share the same vision, and that is that being a girl, it's just a technicality.
Absolutely. And then after the interview, talking about Girls on Fire as a possibility of you and I working together,
yeah.
That was the best.
But we're here to talk about Fire Pit.
I know.
Okay. That's your baby.
So what did you like about, let's talk about that interview. You know, you were hilarious.
Was I?
You were hilarious. Talking about your stunts. Oh my gosh.
Let's talk about me for a minute.
Okay.
Yes. Hannibal Lecter, The Associate, 12 Monkeys, Body Snatchers, The Dark Half, Jacob's Ladder, Tune In Tomorrow,
what?
King of New York.
Oh.
Did I drop anything? Let me pick it up. Perfect Witness.
What?
All these old chestnuts. Plus, I was the queen of the soaps for a long time in New York. Any time a character got pregnant, my mother called me, and I knew 6 weeks later I was falling down the stairs.
Natalie?
Friday show. That's
yeah.
Your baby.
Yeah.
How many episodes are you up to now?
You're going to love this. Over 100.
No way.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And you know what? Well, even since I've met you, the show's evolved a little bit. Originally, it was mostly about musicians.
Now it's all artists.
Photographers.
Filmmakers.
Yeah. Which is how we met.
Yes. Fine artists.
Painters.
Oh, yes. Definitely
illustrators.
Painters.
I mean,
it
encompasses all artists, all art forms.
Yes.
And it appeals to so many people.
And you know what? How many artists do you think there are in Nashville, Tennessee?
Yeah.
Alone.
Well, I mean, I'm amazed alone at, even on the street corners, the musicians, they're all good.
Oh, I know. Everybody in this town, they're here for a reason. And I think being based in Nashville is
the key element to why the fire pit works.
Yeah. And you started in the studio, and now you go out and do live venues too.
Yes. So, oh my gosh, the first performance in the studio. So we're not talking a live performance out in say like the Rutledge or somewhere in Nashville. The first live performance, I'll never forget it. It was a Groove Addiction.
This is Maven from Groove Addiction. Take care of yourselves. I love you more than life itself. Listen to Fire Pit Fridays on Fridays, or save it and listen to it on a Wednesday. Just listen to it. Love you.
And they're not even Groove Addiction anymore. I think they're called The Addiction now, but they're still doing it. And that's pretty interesting, too. Longevity.
Well, and plus, too, the studio, it's such a nice atmosphere. People feel comfortable there.
Yeah.
And you get them to go off on tangents and talk about stuff that they probably shouldn't be talking about.
No.
We have family-oriented show, right?
Yeah.
I heard even for a minute, I didn't realize that Portuguese or people in Portugal were Portuguese.
It's Fire Pit time!
But that's okay. That's the charm of it all.
Well, yeah, and it brings the artist so much closer to the people that are watching, because you also feature up-and-coming artists.
Sure do. And that's, I think that's where the live thing, you know, the live venues,
yeah,
that's where that comes in. The new artist needs to be out there. They need to have exposure, and not everybody can afford publicity.
No.
Yeah.
And you give it to them.
Yeah.
And it's on the internet now. How many, you've got buku viewers?
Over a million.
Wow.
Over a million.
That's unbelievable.
I know. It's kind of an obligation now, Cynthia.
Yeah. And they're dedicated, too.
Yeah. You know what? You got to check out the Steepwater stuff, talking about new artists and then coming to Nashville, being on the Fire Pit, performing live, and then getting signed by a label.
But you've had some really interesting people.
Yeah.
REO Speedwagon.
REO Speedwagon. And that, let me tell you, that... Well, let's watch that footage right now.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Kevin!
Hi there, Sissy.
How are you?
I'm good, babe.
Oh, man, am I excited about you tonight. I can't wait. You bring the house down.
Me too. Playing Nashville is just... It's one of my favorite places in the world
really?
To play. Yeah. Because there's actual songwriters and the audience will be full of people that really are paying attention.
I have a question for you about your moral compass.
Uh-oh. Wow, getting right down to heavy stuff. All right, let's
you know,
go.
Hey, so pretty fun, huh?
You know, you not only do musicians, but you did some TV people this past year.
Yeah, that was pretty exciting. We grabbed the crew and flew up to Philadelphia for that one.
The cheesesteak capital of the world.
Oh, yes. We filmed, we ate, we conquered.
Did you do the Rocky thing on the top?
We did the Rocky thing, yeah. As a matter of fact, we interviewed John Douglas Rainey. He's from the show It Takes a Thief on Discovery Channel.
Yeah.
That was a very interesting piece we did.
Yeah. He's colorful.
Yeah, yeah. Why don't you check it out?
You know, it's funny, a lot of people say, it's who you know,
And I completely disagree. It's who you are when you meet the people that you need to know. And there's always a way that you can carry yourself. There's mm-hmm. always a certain kind of positive energy mm-hmm. that you can always show people that's inside. Even if you don't have the job you want, if you mm-hmm. don't have the money you want, mm-hmm. if you don't have the connections, if you're not at the level of success that you want to be at, there's a way you can carry yourself in a positive manner draws in the right kind of people. And then when you hold on to those people, you start to just build on top of experiences.
You are so right, John.
All right, so musicians, TV people, you have to tell me about Peter Max.
Oh, Cynthia, Peter Max was amazing. You would love him. He was here in Tennessee, and he was unveiling his portrait of Clint Black and his wife, Lisa Hartman. And meeting him for the first time was amazing. His artwork is amazing, but the way he does his artwork is just thrilling.
Well, on top of the fact that he's a pretty private person, so the fact that you scored an interview, pretty good.
Pretty awesome. That's like one of the most memorable interviews that I can say. Yeah.
And the little bird told me you took it to him personally.
Yeah, I hopped on a plane, flew to New York, hand-delivered him the interview, and he was very happy to get it. So, yeah.
That is like the coolest.
Yeah, it's fun.
That's why I'm hanging with you. You're a girl on fire.
When I came out of art school and went around with my heavy portfolio to show people what I did, they all said to me, "This stuff is amazing, Peter, but if we need realism, we just get photography." I came out just when the big photographers, Richard Avedon, Irving Penn, Scavullo, all those guys came out, and nobody needed realism. And so I was heartbroken, on the verge of tears, for 3 months. I didn't even know what to tell my mom and dad. They supported me through art school for 7 years. 7 years, I could have been a doctor. And then one day, because I used to love astronomy, like a huge astronomy buff, I almost made it into astronomy, but I chose art because it was easier for me.
Mm-hmm.
But I used to love astronomy. I used to make these little astronomical drawings, mm-hmm. Saturns and planets. And one day, this art director said to me, "What's this on the bottom of your portfolio?" I said, "Oh, it's nothing," because it wasn't classical. I was classical realism. She said, no, let me see, don't worry. Please, I said, no, it's nothing, please. It's like if Clint, let's say if you were a violinist and you went to Carnegie Hall and they said, "Clint, this is really good stuff you have. What's this new thing?" And you say, "Oh, it's nothing. It's a pair of bongo drums." You know what I mean? Like, you wouldn't want them to know
that.
Like you play bongos when you're like a classical violinist. So that for me, that was the same way. But when I took these out, the 14 art directors in an ad agency, I walked out with 14 projects that day. And when I delivered them, 9 of the 14 got gold medals for the art direction in my work. And then I did 22 more projects. And about 19 of those got gold medals. I won 66 gold medals for the cosmic stuff when I thought I wasn't supposed to even do it. Imagine. And that taught me a lesson. Like, you can go somewhere else.
You can push the envelope and still
I didn't think I was allowed
yourself.
Because Riley would always say to us, "Now, don't get creative on us." Mm. You know, if you're painting the guy with the chin like this, that's what you're painting. You know, don't put like a stroke of red or blue here. Now that's all I do.
That is amazing.
Favorite kind of heart-tugging show?
You know, I do, and it does mean a lot to me. It's my dad, actually.
And your dad?
Yeah, he's Blue Knights of Kentucky. He's
which
the
is a
president.
Motorcycle.
Yeah, it's a motorcycle club, and it was a lot of fun to go to Kentucky
and ride with them.
And ride with the Blue Knights, and they let me do it.
That's so cool.
I know.
I wish I was there.
Oh, do you want me to set it up for next time?
Yeah, do that.
All right, so roll that footage. We're gonna do something exciting and interesting and very unusual. But you know what? It's gonna rock. All right, here we are. 2008, Kentucky chapter president, Blue Knights Motorcycle Club bike ride. Yes, you're invited. So get your motor running. Get out on the highway.
Hi, this is Walt Curtis, president of the Kentucky 8 Blue Knights, and you're listening to Fire Pit Friday.
It's all about the Blue Knights, but kind of couldn't happen unless we were helping out. Buffalo Wild Wings is helping the club out. And you know, this is Dave Thomas, so he should be at Wendy's, but he's not. He's here at Buffalo Wild Wings supporting the Blue Knights. So that rules.
Talk about the Nashville Film Festival. Did we mention that?
We didn't mention it at all.
All right, let's walk down a road and kind of mention that. If we can fit it in.
All right. Oh, wait a minute. I think we just did.
Did we?
We just did.
Did we just mention that? You know what? We're such naturals.
All right.
It doesn't even occur to us. So.
We also filmed the Nashville Film Festival. Check
and
it out.
And the Nashville Screenwriters Conference.
And the Oscars.
Thank you for bringing your film to Nashville.
It's my pleasure. I'm honored to be here.
Now, you co-wrote and produced the movie.
That's right.
And you also play a producer in the movie.
That's right.
Did you get any inspiration from any producers you worked with previously?
Well, as you can well imagine, as an actor for many, many years, it's been my province to make fun of producers.
Yes.
So I found it significant that not only was I a producer in the film, but I was playing a producer. It was a humbling experience. As it turns out, producers are people, too.
Absolutely. And real quick, say to the camera, William H. Macy, you're watching Fire Pit Friday.
Nah, I hate that stuff. I won't do that. But yeah. I am William H. Macy. That part is cool.
William! Go, Macy! Hey, buddy! Hey, Macy, just say it! Say Fire Pit Friday! Say it! Say it! Say Fire Pit Friday!
Wow!
I'm gonna do it! I'm gonna jump!
Don't jump!
No, I'm gonna do it! Are you ready to listen to me? I'm gonna come down there!
Hi, Cindy.
I told you I'd do it. For artists, by artists, and you're an artist, and you didn't say it.
Everyone of you, sit back, relax. The Oscar party tonight here at the Bell Court. And there's even paparazzi, oh my God! This is why we're here tonight, the Oscars. Lots of stars, lots of food. Come on. Do you have a moment to still have a podcast about the Oscars tonight?
Oh, okay.
This is so wonderful.
Yes.
Yes. So here tonight with the beautiful people and celebrating a wonderful, wonderful time. So any choices on the Oscars yourself?
I actually have not been following too much this year, but I do know a French movie for Bells and Butterfly. I don't know whether it's nominated or not, but won the Golden Globe. Yeah, that's about a man who had a stroke and was able to write a whole book with a blink of eyes and quite a courageous. It's a true story.
Emotional. That sounds very emotional. Yeah. Wow. but following, you know what, there's so many, I even have notes on the Oscars, and it seems like it goes on for miles and miles and miles, but I think it's the atmosphere.
That's right, and also the best is always to see those clips of great movies, and see the Lifetime Achievement Award, some of the great actors and actresses.
I know, and here we are at the Belcourt, which is rich in history.
That's right.
Absolutely rich in history.
And also one of the official sites, I understand, by the Motion Picture Academy.
That's right. And what, now what year, 1925, this building was erected. Yes, I know. And it was a silent movie house.
It's almost as old as Academy Award itself, right?
Yes.
Wow.
Isn't that, that's interesting.
Yes.
And so it's almost nostalgic.
That's
I
right.
like that, TV, and your beautiful dancing.
Oh, thank you.
You're a wonderful dancer, by the way.
It's actually, that's my twin brother, look like me.
No! Oh, my goodness. Well, you have a great time tonight. You
thank
look
you.
Marvelous.
Thank you.
Take care.
At the end of 2008. About to start 2009.
Oh my gosh, I'm excited. I'm happy. I'm not worried about it at all.
No, me either.
And you know why?
I know why, but suppose you say so.
All that footage that we shot in Los Angeles.
Which was so much fun.
Uh-huh. It was worth it.
Yep.
It was
all
worth it.
And that's for Girls on Fire.
Right, right. Girls on Fire is 2009 is Girls on Fire year.
Yeah, it is our year. I really feel that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I really do. We had a great year. We met each other.
Mm-hmm.
We clicked.
That's right.
And we're making things happen.
I couldn't think of any better way to kind of close up and start this brand new 2009 on the right foot.
Nope. So you know what we need to do?
Tell me.
We need to go make a wish.
All right, before we make a wish, let's send the viewers to the LA footage. You're going to love it.
Check it out.
And when you come back, get your pennies ready because we're going to make a wish for 2009.
For all of us.
Yeah. Would you watch a show called Girls on Fire?
Will they be hot?
We have the strongest, hottest, most beautiful women on our show.
Yes!
So hello! Girls on Fire is a show about ordinary women.
But so, you never gave up.
If you wanna do it, go for it. It may take you a little while, but don't give up.
Who do extraordinary things.
We set out to find women who can do anything. At any age.
We'll probably have you hovering before you get out of SA.
What kind of man?
That's probably why at my age today I'm still 100%, almost 100% together. Let's show the world who the real Wonder Woman is.
We asked ourselves, can we do what they do? She did really good.
Yeah, she was really good at it.
There was only one way to find out.
And this is our journey.
They're on bonfire.
That's a wrap.
Hi, how you guys doing? My name is Max, and my girlfriend Erica, she's a girl on fire.
On behalf of Fire Pit Friday
and Girls on Fire,
we wish you a happy 2009.
Make a wish.
Hi everybody, this is Sean, your Fire Pit Friday correspondent. Fire Pit Friday, the show for artists, by artists, needs your help. The Fire Pit Studios is under major construction. Are you an artist? Do you have a fire pit? Well then contact us, we want your story. If you live in the Middle Tennessee area, then contact us at fpfthepodcast@mac.com. Well, I gotta get back to the bathroom. I mean, work. See you on the streets.